to talk to Roy in just a minute. Next bout upcoming. What'd you think of Reed?
He's a prospect. He's a real prospect. When you have that kind of power, boy, that you can't coach. That comes with the package.
Ready to look at another fighter with all of the weapons. Young Shane Mosley at 135 pounds, is 26-0 to this stage of his career. Hasn't achieved as much of the spotlight as some other fighters, like, for instance, Reed, because of his Olympic gold medal. But there's a growing groundswell of support for the notion that Mosley, who's called Sugar Shane Mosley, can in fact be compared to predecessors like Sugar Ray Robinson and Sugar Ray Leonard. Larry, 3 months ago when I was in Japan and you did the blow-by-blow on the bout up in Connecticut, Mosley looked sensational in beating the very capable Demetrius Savalas. What do you expect from him tonight?
What a fighter like Mosley does when he creates that high standard is that we all want to see it again and see it over and over in whatever form it takes. That's not easy. But with this young fighter who I've already raised the expectations to much criticism by comparing his style to Sugar Ray Robinson, let me pile on now. Let me say that I believe that nobody has come into the lightweight division as a power boxer, as his father and trainer calls him, like Mosley since Roberto Duran. Now let's see him live up to all of that hype tonight, because it won't be easy against John Molina. John Molina is a terrific old pro, a happy warrior who just loves to fight and can fight. He's lost one fight in the last 8 years, and that was that brawl and maul with Oscar De La Hoya.
Well, which was a pretty close fight. In fact, our Harold Letterman had scored it with Molina beating De La Hoya, and essentially, Roy Jones, Molina gave De La Hoya one of the toughest fights of his career by throwing at him everything but the kitchen sink. Elbows, headbutts, holds, rabbit punches, etc., etc. If he does the same thing to Mosley, is Mosley prepared to look good against a guy like that?
Most definitely. I agree with Larry. I think Shane Mosley is one of the best lightweights that has ever come along in the lightweight division. Tonight, if John comes out and throws everything except the kitchen sink at Shane Mosley is not as nice as Oscar De La Hoya was in his young days. He's going to throw everything but the kitchen sink back at John Molina. So John has better be prepared for what he's throwing out tonight. In other words, do unto others as we have them do unto you.
You're saying Mosley has a mean streak to go with all that talent.
A real mean streak.
It's a useful commodity for a fighter, as we've seen so many times in the past. Let's take a look now at the tail of the tape for Sugar Shane Mosley and John Molina. They both made the lightweight limit of 135 pounds. Mosley tells us that he takes months to get down to 135 and then spends a couple of minutes there. And by tonight, as you see, he weighs 146. Molina weighs 142. A 7-inch reach advantage for Mosley could be tactically significant in the fight because he has an outstanding jab to begin with. And with the 7-inch reach advantage, it could be double trouble for Molina, who's also given up 7 years in age. Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
The Sugar Shane Mosley, John Molina fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the standardized rules for all world championship fights. There is no standing 8-count, no 3-knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight, and you cannot be saved by the bell at any round, including the 12th and final round. Jim.
All right, Harold. Now, John Molina will enter the ring first, and of course, a lifelong Puerto Rican who lives in Fajardo, Puerto Rico, has brought his wife and 3 children to the fight here tonight. Mosley commenting yesterday that he wasn't sure it was such a good idea for Molina to have brought his 3 children because he doesn't think they'll enjoy what they see very much. But John should have plenty of support in the arena tonight. You can hear them as he exits his dressing room.
I wish we had about 100 more fighters around like John Molina.
A closer look at Molina. He's won 24 of his last 25 fights. The only loss in that span was the one
his own horn as a fighter. He lets everybody around him do it. He lets us do it for him. Not exactly shy about himself, but he's not loud either.
And his father has trained him to be, in addition to being a diligent fighter, a gym rat, a student of the sport. This guy has sparred with most of the biggest names on the West Coast, including Genaro Hernandez. He had an amateur fight against De La Hoya all the way back when he was 13 years old. That's 13 years ago. Three amateur fights against fellow welterweight titleist Stevie Johnston, mostly 1-2. Never been knocked down in 286 total fights. He's making his third defense now, the title that he won last summer from Philip Holliday. And now let's go to Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Trump Taj Mahal Casino Resort of Atlantic City, New Jersey, Cedric Kushner Promotions, along with your undisputed, undefeated king of beers, Budweiser, this Bud's for you, present 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Lightweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, Boxing Commissioner Larry Hazard Sr., Chairman Jerry Gormley, Board Members Gary Shaw and Stephen Katz, Deputy Commissioner John Greco. Your four physicians at ringside are Dr. Dominic Coletta Jr., Dr. Richard Snepar, Dr. Charles Wilson, and Dr. Eric Wormser. Timekeeper at the bell, Roosevelt Gilbert. Counting for the knockdown seconds, alternate referee Rudy Battle. This bout is also sanctioned by the International Boxing Federation. President Robert W. Lee, supervisor at ringside for the IBF, is Darryl Peoples. The three judges assigned to score this bout on a 10-point must system will be Deborah Barnes, Paul Herman, and Fred Jones. And when the bell rings, the referee in charge of the action, Ed Johnson. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the Trump Taj Mahal of Atlantic City, New Jersey, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white trunks trimmed with red and blue and weighing in at 135 pounds. His professional record, an excellent one, 45 victories, 30 knockouts to his credit with only 4 losses. Ladies and gentlemen, from Fajardo, Puerto Rico, here is the former 3-time champion of the world, the challenger, Jonjon Molina. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, also weighing in at 135 pounds. He's wearing red, trimmed with gold, and comes to us from Pomona, California. His professional record, a perfect 26 victories without a loss, 24 knockouts to his credit. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the undefeated IBF lightweight champion of the world, Sugar Shane Mosley.
John. Okay, John, Shane, I have given your instructions to the dressing room. I expect a good, clean fight. Touch the glove. When the bell rings, come out fighting. Touch it up, guys. Come on, touch it up.
Jonjon Molina has always given his best, and that's always, almost always been good enough to win. He may have to give better than his best tonight. What does he have left at 33?
Well, one thing he has left is, for a lightweight, the legs of a middleweight. You look at the size and the strength of Molina's legs, it'll make him a little bit tougher to knock out than some other opponents might be. Hard right hand over the top by Mosley to start things off.
Molina does keep his left hand low, so that's another inviting target for a big puncher like Mosley.
Mosley starts off throwing lead right hands to try to take advantage of that low left hand by Molina.
Yes, but Mosley can't get too anxious. If he does, he'll find himself in the same situation that Oscar found himself in.
Punch out of it. Come on, guys. Punch out of it.
Boy, a lot of people thought the Sabalos fight 3 months ago represented Mosley's best performance. What kind of progress did you see him making there?
I saw him make a great deal of progress. He wasn't too impatient. He took his time. He worked his opponent's body. He wore his opponent down, and then he destroyed him. That's the way you should, a young fighter should do it, man.
Oh,
man.
Punch in there. Right. Step back.
1 minute into the first round. Mosley not yet working to establish his jab. He's got a good one.
Watch the head. Watch the head. Watch the head.
Reason being, Jim, is he's trying to find out can John John take his power shots early. To do things here, though.
Let's go.
You can tell he has a little bit more respect for John John than he has for previous opponents.
Molina, a guy who stays in shape. He's used to fighting 6-7 times a year. He's used to winning, as we've pointed out. Stable family man, no bad habits. Ready to fight every time he comes into the ring.
And going to the body quite a bit here in the early part of the fight.
To the neck of Mosley.
The reason he was able to land that shot, Jim, is because Mosley's back is straight up from Molina. He's not going left or right with his back, and then he's going straight back.
So Molina just followed along and went with him.
Followed him to that spot.
Mosley, as Molina holds on to his left arm, takes advantage to rake him with right-hand shots. Molina accusing Mosley of fouling. Referee Ed Johnson says, hey, straighten up and fly right.
Come on, right.
And Molina immediately begins some of the nonsense you saw against De La Hoya, holding Mosley around the back of the head with his left arm.
It's not nonsense, it's protection, and it's anything you can to disrupt the young fighters.
Right.
He gave him the bruise of your eye right there. So
he had been.
Yeah, but you used to get in front of him. Boxing, like we said we would do. Okay? He needs something on his eye right here. Okay, boxing. You're doing great. Put him out. Okay, just boxing.
Okay. Será só um
There was the right hand early in the round by Mosley. And later, Molina, after throwing some body shots, comes right over the top with his right hand.
Bang your corner, John John. Back in the corner.
Pretty even by punch stat numbers. Mosley landing 18 of 47, only 10 of 39 for Molina, but Molina's 10 punches landed were all power shots, most of them to the body.
Jim, this could turn into a condition fight. Who's ever in the best condition could be the winner of this fight.
Why do you say that, Roy?
Well, because both guys are kind of even right now. Nobody has established a supreme dominance in the fight yet. And if it continues to go this way, whoever weakens first will be the guy who will be dominated.
And you heard Jack Mosley asking his son between rounds to box Molina. Shane still not having established his jab. Molina landing just under the chin of Mosley. So he's now landed to the side of the neck and the front of the neck. Molina doesn't expect to make it pretty. He just wants to get the leather on you somehow.
He's all about winning, Jim.
Guys, punch out of there, come on. Right, step back.
Hard right hands by Molina, driving Mosley back into the ropes. John Molina making a physical imprint on the bout midway through round two.
There again, Shane Mosley's backing straight up, and it's allowing him to be wide open for those great punches that John Jones is throwing.
Hard right hand to the body by Mosley, or check it by Molina, I should say, and then Mosley landed a left uppercut in return, and Molina comes back with a right hand of his own.
Molina's a very smart fighter. He sits out there, he bounces, he loves the guy to be still. Just when he thinks when the guy thinks he's not coming is when he comes. So they're never expecting him to attack when he attacks.
Yeah, he has a kind of a staccato style. It's a hip-hop rhythm.
And it's so hard for these counterpunchers to counter him because they don't know when he's coming.
And he likes it. He just likes it. And as we go to John Molina's corner where they speak Spanish, our interpreter is Hector Garcia.
You're doing really good. You're doing great. Give him some water.
You have the conditions. You can do this. You have better conditions. You worked a lot for this. You have better conditions. You have the conditions for this. It's like a machine. He can't beat you. You're like a machine. And you're very smart. Very smart. And the experience is there.
Molina said to us that Mosley's never fought anyone like him. And I think Molina was absolutely right.
Round three, John Molina against Shane Mosley. Mosley, the heavy favorite, of course. Extraordinarily talented young fighter. Molina, with his unusual style, giving Mosley all he can handle in the first couple of rounds. Right hand landed for Mosley. And as Molina momentarily stops punching, Shane comes in. Now Molina firing back.
Okay, punch out. Come on, guys. Punch in there. Come on. Let's go. Punch in there. Come on. Use your head. Punch out of there. All right.
Anytime Molina can make Mosley wait and look for the big punches, he can land punches.
Mosley trying to wrestle Molina into the ropes. Hard right hand lands over the top for Mosley, and this time Molina is wobbled. Mosley expending a lot of energy, and Molina comes back with a right hand shot to the body. Molina was knocked down in the first round by De La Hoya. Then gave De La Hoya a lot of trouble for the next 10 rounds. In the 12th round, De La Hoya came out and closed the show with a brilliant display that made him the winner in the fight.
Break, guys. Come on, break.
Roy, do you think Mosley did have Molina hurt earlier in the round?
Oh, he had him hurt more definitely. He has him hurt
him
right
again.
Now. He's a bigger puncher at this weight than De La Hoya was.
Come on. Right.
If he takes his time and quit trying to knock John out,
give a break.
He'll eventually land
give
a knockout
break.
Punch to knock him out, but as long as he's looking for it, he may have a hard time.
Oh, saw the excellent footwork of the young champion as he pivoted into position to fire that left hook.
And he has such quick hands, Jim. It's so beautiful to watch him throw these quick combinations.
He's a real classic fighter.
That he is.
Take it. He's 33 years old. I can see him fading right now. Okay? He can't take it. Those body shots, if you go to the body, take that air out, you knock him out within 8 rounds. I mean, don't throw caution to the wind now.
Okay.
But get close enough so you can nail some more of those right hands. He's dropping his head. You shoot shoot a right hand. If his head goes over the way, come back with a left hook. Because you're setting him up for the left hook.
Watch Mosley operate as he throws punches around the left hand of Molina. Almost looks improvised because Molina is keeping that left out there to ward off the straight right hand, Roy.
Okay, suckers out! Suckers out! Man in the corner, in the corner. Job, job, back in the corner. In the corner, back in the corner. Same, back in the corner. Box.
That left hand is used a good defense mechanism against a straight right lead, Larry.
Mosley smiling across the ring at you, Roy, and shaking his head as if to say, huh, he's a rough customer.
Yeah, he's complaining a little bit about the headbutts, I think. But he's coming back.
There was a little scrape over Mosley's left eye at the end of round one, but Cassius Green, the cut man, has done good work with that. And you saw Mosley landing that quick step-in left hook against Molina to stop Molina in his tracks momentarily. Molina gets a little left hook in.
Yeah, but Molina's punches have lost the steam that they once had on.
Oh, no knockdown, no knockdown, no knockdown. Come on, come on, come on, come on. That's five.
Good call by the referee, Eddie Johnson. Although Molina's glove touched the canvas, it was obviously more of a push than a punch that got him there.
Yeah, but Molina seems to be weakening now. You see Shane guiding around the ring with one hand now. At the beginning of the fight, they both were manhandling one another.
Punch him, punch him, let him go. Punch out, guy, punch him there.
The point you made in the opening on camera is certainly correct, Roy. When Molina wrestles with Shane, Shane wrestles him back. He doesn't turn and look to the referee for help as some fighters would.
No, he doesn't want help. He knows he's a man and he's out there to protect himself. He's not worried about the referee getting John John off of him.
Saw the flicking left jab of Mosley. He's very quick with that punch, too. Haven't seen it a lot so far in the fight. Mosley's father, Jack, asking for more body punching and telling him to get close enough to throw more right hands. And there's an uppercut, well thrown.
And his father knows that if he continues to weaken John John by beating him to the body, he'll soon be able to knock him out with a head shot. But John John has also been beating Shane's body.
Professional work through the first few rounds. Larry, let's put Shane Mosley in context with the rest of the lightweight division.
I like him too. So
there are two other belt holders, Nazarov, the Russian, who is very, very highly regarded, and Stevie Johnson of Denver, who will appear underneath the Oscar De La Hoya fight. Next month, so we'll get a first chance to look at Stevie Johnson live June the 13th.
And you can see that the CompuBox punch stat numbers from round to round are growing ever more lopsided now in Mosley's favor.
Okay, suckers out. John, John, in the corner. John, John, back in the corner. Back in the corner. Come on.
At the end of that last round, you saw some classic John John Molina. He waits for the referee to break him. Before the guy can get set, he attacks right away. Keeps his opponent behind him.
Harold, how about these first four rounds?
Jim, I got it. 3-1, 39-37. Sugar Shane Mosley. I did give the second round to John John Molina, but basically, Shane Mosley's winning this because he's the hardest, sharper puncher. You know, it's a rough fight, though. A lot of headbutts, real headbutts in rounds one and three, and a lot of low blows for John John Molina.
I have the same score, funny enough, Harold.
Great step back. Same
man. Larry, you don't have any even rounds this time? I can't believe it.
When they're even, I'll call them even.
Roy Jones with another body shot, this time delivered to Larry Merchant. But unlike Virgil Hill, Merchant isn't down. Saw a good quick left hook by Mosley, and now Molina leaps forward and lands a left hook himself. But landed punches are fewer and farther between now for John John Molina. And you saw the CompuBox numbers that showed he landed only six in the last round. Here he lands a leaping right hand and gets in a couple of thrusts to the body before Ed Johnson breaks him apart. And roused to action, Mosley leaps up to try to throw an overhand right. Molina grabs him instead.
A good body shot by Shane Mosley. Both fighters are working to the body very good in these early rounds.
Hard right hand to the back of Mosley's, or Molina's head, I should say, by Shane Mosley. Right above the ear. Couple of more right hand shots. Mosley landing not only more frequently, but more sharply as the seconds tick away.
He's going for broke here, Jim. He wants Molina out of here.
And his father would say, don't forget the body punches and don't get too impatient.
Yeah, because he can wear himself out like this. John John's hit him to the body every chance John John gets. He's throwing the big punches. They work you twice as hard as throwing the regular punches.
Molina took a terrific right hand near the end of that round. But he also showed against Oscar De La Hoya after that early knockdown that he can take a big punch.
But I need you to go to that body a little more. He can't take those body shots.
He's holding me to the back here.
But, okay, every time you hit him, and you move out of the way, okay, don't stay right there in front of him. Hit him with a good shot. If you're not, but you got to throw two, three punches, Shane. You got to, like, bang, 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 okay? You're the champ. You're the power boxer. He can't take it, Shane. He's 33 years old.
Right.
Okay? And if you keep hitting him in the body, it's going to show up. Now, you can take probably those head shots.
You have to move back. You have to move your lower body. He's tired. He's very tired. He's a lot more tired than you are. Use that straight right hand. Throw it. Just throw it.
There's that good right hand. That one landed behind the ear. Later on, he landed right on the jaw. Molina stood up to it.
Round six begins. Molina with a couple of red welts on that shaven skull of his, otherwise unmarked. And Shane Mosley shows no ill effects from the first five rounds of action with John John.
This is not as ugly a fight as Molina felt he had to make against the younger De La Hoya when he fought him. But he's still a very hard guy to fight.
Punch out. Right. come on, guys, give me a break.
Well, and maybe it's not quite as ugly a fight because, as Roy pointed out, even before the bout began, Mosley would give back whatever he got.
Yeah, he's not looking for the referee to help him out or to get him out of this ugly fight. He's doing it himself. He's taking care of things like he's supposed to. He's the champion. He's supposed to take care of himself out there.
Which may say to Molina, I'm not going to get to this guy with the rough stuff the way I got to Oscar a few years ago.
Yeah, it definitely says that. But I can tell you one thing, Jim. Molina is still in this fight in a big way. Oh, headbutt again.
Let's go.
Well, Molina will never fully go away until he's counted out or they read the scorecards at the end. He's a gamer. Another thunderous right hand over the top by Shane Mosley. And another right cross landed flush. Chopping style that time. Mosley a little bit more frequent with the left jab now, Roy, and I like that.
And that disrupts Molina's come. Molina likes to wait and come when you're not ready, but that jab would make him stay out there for a little bit longer.
Mosley didn't work in the early rounds to establish his jab, but numerically he lands it more than half the time, and it's making the right cross easier and easier to land.
Excellent body shot by Shane Mosley.
Big round for Mosley so far in number six.
Yeah, now he's establishing his dominance in the fight.
Watch behind the hole.
Mosley switching southpaw for a few seconds and then turns back to his regular stance. Jab, jab. Straight right hand as Molina comes in. Molina reaching and trying to find a way to punch at Mosley. Mosley hitting him as he arrives.
Tell me what's going on. Tell me what's going on. We have to fight fast and strong with this guy. You got to throw that, put that hand, right hand up. You're going to have to run. You're going to have to run and fight five hard.
The right hand from Mosley in different parts of this round. It's the weapon that Molina can't seem to get out of the way of.
Okay, Sucker's out, let's go. Sucker's out, Molina calling.
Now you see it also coming behind that jab a lot.
Yep. I like
let's
that
go,
last
let's
right
go,
hand.
Let's go.
Vicious. Still with plenty of energy, trying to get at Mosley's body, occasionally pot shotting to the head. Making it clear to Shane that his effort level doesn't go down. Mosley landing another one of those withering right-hand shots as Molina came in at it.
Punch him there.
for Shane Mosley right here, Jim. Fighting inside, brawling with a real natural-born brawler. You can't get any better experience than he's getting right now.
Outbox the boxers, out punch the punchers, out brawl the brawlers. What else is there? Good punch by Molina. Still coming.
The reason he's landing these shots now is because Shane doesn't have much head movement. He's brawling with him, so he's not moving his head as much as he normally does.
I think he may believe that he has softened Molina up, that he's looking to land a big shot, and so he stopped moving his head a little bit. You're right, Roy. There's another little right hand.
In training just for this fight, guys, Shane Mosley sparred in the gym in Los Angeles with Genaro Hernandez, 130-pound champion. About it. Referee Ed Johnson had no hesitation in calling it a knockdown.
It didn't look like a clean knockdown. Partly Molina was off balance. Partly it may have been some fatigue. It was a left hand, however, that started him down.
If the punch touches you and you go down, that's a knockdown.
Well, let's take another look.
Very end of the round.
Oh, that's a knockdown.
Yeah, that's a knockdown.
Clean in my book.
And it looked like a jab, Roy. While he was coming in to try to do some damage, a jab puts him down.
Yep. And that substantiates your point, Roy, about when the guy is coming in at you at the moment when you hit
that,
it doubles the impact.
Doubles the impact every time.
Believe it or not, John Molina has a job between fights as a phone repairman and installer. But right now it seems to me that he may have to call 411 to get information on how to fight this youngster, or 911 to get some help.
I think the help would be better.
Yeah, because Mosley is trying to dilate for long distance against him.
And here he comes.
Molina coming out with a fury. Set at the knockdown ruling at the end of the last round. And Molina landing with passion.
This is what you like to see in these game fighters. You like to see a guy with some courage, with some heart. He has dignity, he has pride.
Well, he's a champ. He's got a champion's mentality as a fighter.
Three-time world titleist, won 24 of his last 25 fights. Not used to taking no for an answer. Not terribly impressed by Shane Mosley's reputation. I was about to tell you before the knockdown in the last round, Mosley sparred with Genaro Hernandez, Sammy Fuentes, David Kamau, Obakar, all of them name fighters. Carr's a welterweight. But the guy he said most reminded him of John Molina is a fighter named Hector Lopez, who uses a lot of the same tricks and has a lot of the same resilience. And look at him, trade shots against the ropes.
Now that's boxing after dark.
Yep. It's becoming a bad bout.
Oh.
Do we think the old guy is on Viagra?
I don't know, but he just got hurt with a left body shot. Oh, there's another left body shot.
I just hope he goes down soon so that I can say Viagra Falls.
Yeah, he's hurting pretty bad now. It's hard for him to protect himself. I think he's coming close to the end.
A left and a right, another right. All solid shots by Mosley. Referee Ed Johnson looking carefully.
Those body shots are doing terrible damage to Molina.
The ref should stop this fight. You see the man can't protect himself. Please, ref. Come on, why you gotta take this?
Good stoppage, finally. And that was a fascinating round because Molina came out firing as if to say, I'm going to show you who the real man is here. And Mosley matched him and doubled him.
Right. It was his last hurrah in that fight. And I think we can say that John Molina has never in a wonderful career been dominated by a fighter the way he was tonight. He's been beaten, but I doubt that he's ever been dominated this way.
That's how it gets down in the front.
Okay, let him throw it out.
We stretch them all out.
Throw it.
In round eight, Shane Mosley landed 33 of the 51 punches he threw, including 31 of 48 power shots. It was a display of effective counterpunching aggression against a guy who came out trying to make a statement against him. Mosley stepped up and said, okay, fire your best, because it's coming back harder every time.
That's right. And the one thing I like about what Mosley did was his father beckoned him to go to the body early. He told his father that Molina was holding him too much. He wanted to wait. He waited to the best time. He wore him down some. Then he went inside and brought him, took advantage of Molina's weakening body, and it made the head punches take a toll. And Molina just couldn't stand up under the pressure. He broke him down.
And it showed you that the thought process in Mosley's corner works both ways.
Yes, it does.
Fighter and trainer.
Yes, the fighter usually knows when it's best to take the chances, because he's the one who's actually taking the punches. The father knew exactly what to tell him, but Shane had to take his time to get that understood.
Say, Stevie Johnson,
well said, Roy.
Make a statement.
Promoter Cedric Kushner chatting with Mosley, and let's take a look at some replays of the brilliant action in that round.
The first thing I heard him was a left body shot under his right hand. And that was a good head shot, but all of that was a repercussion. Body shot.
Oh, boom.
There's that first body shot. That's what started everything.
And at this point, Molina was all but finished. Wanted to keep fighting, of course, because his desire is unquenchable. But it was just a matter of time, and you heard Roy Jones asking the referee to step in and stop it seconds before Ed Johnson did as Roy expected him to do. Good work by Shane Mosley to the body and to the head in the eighth round, as John Molina, angered by a knockdown at the end of the preceding round, came out aggressive and therefore gave Mosley the opportunity he needed to go ahead and finish. Now let's go to Michael Buffer for the official particular.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ed Johnson has to call a halt to the bout. The official time, 2 minutes, 27 seconds of round number eight. The winner by TKO victory, still the undefeated IBF lightweight champion of the world, Sugar Shane Mosley.
And now here to talk to Sugar Shane Mosley is Vinegar Bend Larry Merchant.
Thank you, Jim, and congratulations again, Sugar. I think you've earned that title, Sugar.
Oh, yeah.
This guy was not easy. Why not? What did it take to finally break him down?
Well, I think the body shots finally broke him down. You know, he is a very tough fighter. He throws, you know, you can't just watch him fight. You have to be in there with him. He throws those funny punches, and he can catch you from different angles. So you have to really be cautious when you're fighting him. But I think the body shots broke him down. And I noticed before he was available for a lot of right hands, Larry. So.
But he also has the mentality of a champion. I mean, he tried to make a fight of it right to the end.
Oh, yeah. He wanted to prove that he was still the champion, but I had to let him know that there's a new champion in town. And for all those other lightweights, I think they can take on this Stevie Johnson and Orzabek Nazarov. I'm right here.
You're getting unusually bold.
Well, you know, I'm bold. I mean, I like Stevie Johnson. You know, we grew up and we did the amateur career together. I don't know Osborne Nazarov, but you know, I just think that the fans would like to see good fights like this.
All right, your dad, in fact, called it early in the fight. Says you'll get him in eight if you use your left hand a little bit and if you go to the body. Were you a little too anxious early on?
Well, yeah, you know, I started hitting him with, you know, the jabs and stuff, and I figured I caught him early with the right hand. So I said, yeah, that right hand, that's my bread and butter shot. So I'm going to catch him again with that right hand. My father said, well, calm down, hit him in the body first, and then go back to the right hand. But, you know, I think I just got too anxious, and I started throwing one punch at a time instead of throwing the combinations. And I probably would have got him out early if I would have threw more combinations.
Are guys like me raising the expectations for you too high, Sugar, to live up to?
Well, Larry, I don't think so. You know, I have to live up to that expectation. I have to be, you know, I want to be great. And I want to be, you know, one of the greats, you know, like the Roy Jones, Oscar De La Hoyas, and the Prince Nassims. I want to be, you know, among those guys. And I think right now that I am among those guys, Roy, Oscar, and the Prince. And there's probably some others, too, out there. I'm not Evander Holyfield. You know, they have the Tysons and, you know, everybody like that. So, you know, I just want...
So you like the expectations, and it somehow inspires you?
That motivates me to do the best that I possibly can do.
And that's the way to be. Thank you again, Shane.
Thank you, Larry. I appreciate it.
Okay. And that's both part.
You know, a lot of fighters down through the years have taken on the appellation of Sugar in homage to the great Sugar Ray Robinson. But there's only been two that I've seen who have really earned those appellations, Sugar Ray Leonard and this young man we just saw, Sugar Shane Mosley. Jim?
All right, Larry, final punch stat numbers, and you'll see the dominance of Mosley there as he landed 111 more punches and threw 38 more, 55% connect percentage. That's pretty withering for the opponent. He was leading on all three scorecards at the time when the fight was stopped. One judge gave the first two rounds to Molina, but other than that, it was a whitewash for Mosley, who won every other round on all three judges' cards. And Stevie Johnston, one of the other welterweight champions whose name was mentioned there, you'll see him on the undercard of the Oscar De La Hoya-Patrick Charpentier fight, June 13 in El Paso, right here on HBO. We'll have a final word on what happened here in the ring in just a moment. Now let's look ahead to some upcoming HBO programs.